From my perspective, I've seen significant amount of openness and world-class expertise that is necessary for outstanding research that truly helps the planet. My lab specializes in how infrastructure systems respond and interact through soil during different extreme demands from disasters. When a disaster occurs, aside from the devastation that it causes, it also presents an opportunity to learn. It's a natural laboratory that we can learn from so that we can prevent such damage in the design of the next phase of our infrastructure as we move forward, particularly for climate-related hazards that will continue and will get worse. CIEST stands for Center for Infrastructure, Energy and Space Testing, and it brings together or merges large-scale testing facilities in the geotechnical and structural engineering sides of our department, civil, environmental and architectural engineering. We have three different centrifuges. One of them is used for instruction, which is itself very unique. We teach undergraduate students about centrifuge modeling, which, you know, I don't think many other universities can claim. The largest centrifuge facility is 6 meters in radius, so it's one of the largest, and in terms of G-ton capacity, it's one of the strongest, most powerful ones among the academic institutions in the U.S. The RYZE interdisciplinary research theme, which is an initiative within the College of Engineering and Applied Sciences, it stands for Resilient Infrastructure for Sustainability and Equity. The goal is to merge considerations of resilience with environmental sustainability and social justice or equity. And as far as we know, there is no other center in the world, perhaps, that merges all three considerations at the same time and brings researchers to study various aspects of resilience in this manner. We have the resources here, we have the right people, and we have the right facilities, and we have the right atmosphere for bringing folks together and making things happen.